work with Dr. Alex Unas from the Department of Pharmacology and Toxicology. We're currently looking at the chemical PFOA, which stands for perfluorooctanoic acid. It was a chemical that was used in the past for the making of Teflon and other materials. PFOA is currently not in use because it's not biodegradable, so it's persistent in our environment. It's in our water, it's in our wildlife, and it's in our blood. So humans all have a blood level of PFOA. And depending on where you live, of course, you know, your blood level is going to be different. We're looking at how PFOA is cleared from the body, specifically the renal excretion of PFOA. We want to identify the different transporters in the kidney that clear out PFOA so that we can identify like the pharmacological implications that go along with that to see if it interferes with the excretion of other compounds in our body or compounds that we take, like medications. One of the ways that we came to assess this was through experiments with mice. We had two groups of mice. One group received the chemical, PFOA, and another group was the control group that didn't receive anything. Their kidneys were homogenized. They were ran through a Western blot analysis. The Western blot separates the protein in the kidney by molecular weight. After we ran the Western blot, we then compare the amount of protein of interest to see if the PFOA had induced the transporters that we're looking at. For instance, we looked at MRP4, and the mice that were treated with PFOA had higher levels of MRP4. This correlates obviously with the PFOA that they were treated with and may indicate that PFOA induces the transporter and possibly transports the chemical. Prior to doing my research or just getting involved in research in general, I never had the intention of thinking about going to grad school. After starting my research, I felt like there are definitely more options out there. And grad school was definitely one of them. Research was one of them. Before, it was kind of like you heard about research and you learned about techniques in class, but it was kind of like something that was out there. But when you're actually in the lab and you're doing it and you become more competent at it and you feel like this is something that you can actually do as a living, and you're working alongside with other grad students, and Dr. Alexuna, she's constantly sharing her grad school experiences, and so it becomes something that seems more realistic and something that I feel that if I wanted to, I would be able to do.